Hi guys, welcome back at the International Talent Event Amsterdam, live broadcasted from the Student Hotel. We just had the 10-minute pitches from ACE Information Development and Blue Horseshoe Solutions. If you want to know more about them, feel free to contact them. Right now you can also join the job fair with Blue Horse Solutions. But now we'll move on to what is ISAC. If you are still thinking about whether or not you want to book a chat with a career coach, you still have the opportunity to do that. Just send an email to partner@amsterdamtalent.com and we will look if there is still a spot left for you. Also, if you want to get a chance to win a one-on-one talk with Coach Rob, share the video and we might announce you as a winner later. For now, we'll move on to the what is ISAC session.
Yeah, so welcome. As told before, ISAC is organizing this event today, so we would also like to introduce the organization. My name is Merel. I am part of the ITEA team. I did acquisition mainly, and I am here with Justin. Justin, can you maybe shortly introduce yourself?
Yes, so my name is Justin, and I am in ISAC in Amsterdam as chairman or president, I would like to call it.
Okay, sounds cool. So can you tell me a bit about like what is ISAC exactly?
Yeah, so ISAC is a platform for young people to develop their leadership qualities. We do this by providing cross-cultural exchanges abroad and by guiding those exchanges. Our goal is to strive for a better world through mutual understanding.
Okay, so that sounds like a lot. Maybe it's good to break it down a bit. So where did this organization start? How did it start?
Yeah, so after World War II, a group of young people came together and they agreed that this should never happen again. They wanted to strive for world peace and at the same time a world where everyone can be the best version of themselves. And today, this is still the goal of our organization.
Okay, so you want to make the world a better place. That is a huge goal. So I would like to know, how do you approach that within ISAC?
Yeah, true. No, it's a very big goal. And with such a big goal, there are a lot of different approaches for reaching that goal. And our approach is maybe not the most obvious one, because it's more indirect. We do not strive for reaching our goal by directly influencing politics or international relations, because that's very complex. Our approach is more, I would say, individually, because we believe that the world is defined by the people who live in it. So if we can develop the people, we can actually make a positive impact on the world. And more specifically, we try to develop certain capacities in young people, so that if they have these capacities, it will be easier for them to make a positive impact on the world in their lifetimes. So for example, in their job, but also more on the local environment, in their friends or family.
Okay.
Yeah. So we think that if we can develop those qualities in many young persons, then in the long run, we will be closer to world peace and a world where everyone can be the best version of themselves.
Okay, yeah, that sounds super interesting. So you try to develop capacities in young people so they have a positive impact on the world. And then as a result, we can make the world a better place in the long run. Okay, but what capacities are you talking about then?
Yeah, so we identify four qualities which are critical for making this positive contribution to the world. Those are self-awareness, solution-orientedness, empowering others, and being a world citizen. And let me explain briefly what those qualities entail. So the first one is self-awareness. It's about knowing who you are, knowing your strengths and weaknesses, knowing your personal values, and knowing your passions. We think that this is key for making a positive contribution to the world. Like, if you don't know yourself, how can you ever help others then?
Okay, yeah.
And the second one is solution-orientedness. By this, we mean showing resilience in the face of challenges, or only focus on what's inside your circle of influence and not put too much effort on what's outside there, or staying positive while being in uncertainty. In the complex world we live in right now, we think that these are very important skills. The third one is empowering others. If we want to strive for a world where everyone can be the best version of themselves, it's not enough if everyone only focuses about their own development. We think that if you help and empower others in their development, and if you try to learn from others for your development, to realize grow will be of way more value. And then we have the last one, the last quality, and that's being a world citizen. And by that we mean being able to work in an international environment, be aware of current world issues, taking responsibility about them, and also believing that you can actually make a change.
Okay. So you want to develop these qualities, and then with that you try to, well, you try to like teach people or help them to make a positive impact on the world around them, which in the end would make the world a better place. What I noticed when I was informing myself about Isaac is that you come across the term leadership a lot. So I was wondering, how does leadership fit in with those qualities and the goal of your organization?
Yeah, no, true. So what I said in the beginning, ISEC is a platform for young people to develop their leadership qualities. And with that, I mean the four qualities I just mentioned. So leadership for us is not about having power or being the boss. No, leadership is about making this positive contribution to the world. So, for example, like this, that can be very locally. So for example, if I, through my behavior, make a positive impact on you, then that's already an act of leadership. Yeah, you don't need to be prime minister to act as a leader. So instead of saying we want to develop certain capacities in young people, we often say in ISEC we want to develop responsible young leaders.
Okay. And so these capacities that you develop, you believe as an organization that that will mean that you will become responsible young leaders.
Yeah.
Okay. But then this is all a very nice philosophy and an idea and a purpose, but what is still quite vague to me is, what do you actually do to reach this with the with the people who are within your organization?
Yeah. So we try to develop those four qualities in young people by putting them in challenging environments and also practical environments. That's important. So we believe that you can develop yourself in the best way possible if you're outside your comfort zone and if you experience that in practice. So not through a book or a lecture. And more specifically, those challenging environments for us are internships and volunteering projects abroad. So on a daily basis, we organize internships and volunteering projects abroad. But what's also important here is that, and that's maybe a unique part of our organization, is that also the guidance of those projects, the facilitation of those projects, is a challenging and practical environment. So while we're trying to develop those four qualities, those four leadership qualities, in the people who go with us abroad, we at the same time try to develop those four qualities in the people who actually facilitate those experiences, so in our members. And especially now in the current context of the world, like we are in a pandemic, that aspect of our organization becomes very apparent. Because like normally our exchanges are like intercontinental. Most people want to go to Africa or South America or Asia, but now that cannot happen anymore. So we had to shift our focus like more regional to Europe. So it was a huge challenge. We had to adapt our marketing strategies. We had to create new partners in Europe. So while we couldn't do as much exchange as we would like to do, we were still in this challenging environment, and hence we had the opportunity to develop those qualities. So still, like the last months, We didn't do any exchanges, but still, on a daily basis, we were working towards our main goal.
Okay. I think I kind of understand it. So you put people in practical and challenging environments, and that I could see how that helps with your personal development and developing these qualities, but I don't really see yet how it is kind of a necessity, how being in a practical and challenging environment in itself will get you to develop those qualities. So how do these things relate to one another?
Yeah, no, true. I can imagine that you don't see that connection right away, because indeed it's not a necessity. You do not develop those leadership qualities, those four leadership qualities, if you are in this challenging environment. There needs to be something more. And the key here is that in every ISCA experience, you have a support system who guides you throughout your whole journey, ranging from setting personal goals at the start to reflection on those goals and the shown behavior during and after your journey. So we believe that if you have someone who helps you identify your personal goals and confronts you with your behavior throughout your journey, you actually have the opportunity to develop those four leadership qualities.
Okay, so by putting young people in a practical and challenging environment and giving them the support you need, you try to develop the leadership qualities in young people so that later in life, or from that moment onwards, they can have a positive impact on their environment. And in that way, on a larger scale, you try to contribute to peace and people becoming the best version of themselves.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, that's a very nice purpose and a very nice goal, but I'm also very curious how this would work in practice. So for that, I would also like to introduce Ella, who is currently a member of ISAC. Hi, so Ella, can you maybe shortly introduce yourself?
Yep, sure. So my name is Ella, and I've done a few different things with ISAC. I was first an exchange participant, and then I was a part-time member, and now I'm a full-time member. So I've had a few years, but now I'll be talking about my part-time experience.
Cool. Yeah, so you did your part-time experience last year, I think?
Yeah.
Yeah. So how did you experience being part of ISAC in Amsterdam?
I found it to be a really special experience because I had never been given so much responsibility before. I was managing in total probably about 20 people throughout the year, and it was a big professional learning experience because I had never had so much so much responsibility before. And another really special thing about it is, alongside, you know, the room for growth, is that you're with a bunch of other young people who are also looking to grow. And you have weekly dinners together and bottles and fun activities, of course, when the pandemic is not happening. So you also make a lot of friends, and it's just a really nice experience.
Yeah. So let's go a bit more into your professional development. Like, what was your function? What did you do within ISAC?
Yep, so I was the manager of something called the NOR project. So it's a voluntary project in the Middle Eastern region, and it's entirely organized by local students in those Middle Eastern countries. And then we partner with them and send people there. And so, yeah, I manage that project for Amsterdam.
Okay, sounds indeed like a huge responsibility. Justin, just talk to us about how being in such a practical environment and challenging environment might help you develop your leadership qualities. Do you also recognize that in your term?
For sure, especially with really learning to be solution oriented, because if you're managing exchange participants, they're going to inevitably have some issues or questions, and you're the go-to person when it comes to answering those and problem solving. So I really learned to be quicker with finding solutions and more efficient. And I think I also became more self-aware, because a special thing about ISAC is that you're with other young people who are on kind of the same playing field as you. So when we have feedback sessions and when we reflect on our experiences, we can really understand each other and give, I think, more valuable feedback than you can get from someone who is from a very different part of their career and maybe doesn't understand where you're at as much.
Cool, sounds super interesting. So does this, like the feedback sessions and like solution oriented, it sounded quite like based on your function and the feedback maybe also more related to the support system Justin was talking about. How did you feel like getting into this challenge and being supported and guided throughout your board position?
Yeah, so I felt really supported throughout. So there is sort of a leadership structure where you have your own kind of team leader, and then they have their own team leader. But there's also a lot of room for taking initiative because we all are young people and we're all in the same boat. So I always felt like if I had an idea or I wanted to change something, I could do that and I would be encouraged to do that. And I think that's something you don't get in a normal part-time job or a normal entry career position.
Okay, so that's like that sounds like you had a really good experience. I'd also like to ask you, and maybe you already touched upon it a bit, but I'm not sure, like what makes ISAC unique to you? Like there are a lot of student like organizations and things you can do in your student life, but why was it ISAC for you, and why did you, in that sense, were apparently willing to continue?
Yeah, I think the special thing about ISAC is, like I said before, that it's youth powered and that it's also youth empowering, that everyone who's part of ISAC really is encouraged to stand up and have their own voice in the organization. But you know, a lot of committees and organizations are youth powered. But what makes ISAC different is that it's international. It's actually the largest like youth international organization in the world. And because of that, there's a great level of responsibility and complexity in ISAC that you don't find in a smaller organization, because we're working with cross-cultural exchanges. We're communicating with partners in Tunisia, in Ghana, and this is this other level that really makes the responsibility greater and also makes the experience more enriching.
Sounds really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So now we've discussed like your experience as a part-time member where you guided some students, but maybe next it's also interesting to go to one of our trainees who is on an internship from Bulgaria actually and is currently doing an internship in Amsterdam.
Hello guys.
Hi Anna, how are you doing?
Great, thank you.
Can you maybe like shortly introduce yourself, like what company are you working for? How did you, what are you doing right now in life?
Yes, so I came to the Netherlands last year in September, but then I for an internship that was part of my master's degree, and then I continued my internship life in Amsterdam as part of a software company called Validate. I'm a test automation engineer there, which is also the major in my master's degree. And that experience started in April. I'm actually now a full-time member in the company. So I hope the best is yet to come, as I believe. Yes.
Cool. Yeah. So you were already in the Netherlands and you then decided to apply for another traineeship through ISAC in Amsterdam. So why did you choose to go on an exchange with ISAC or another internship?
Yeah, actually I was part of ISAC 4 or 5 years ago. I was part of a project called Business in Practice. So I was part of, again, in the of the financial team that was responsible for this project that is again connecting students with the business. So I had some kind of a feeling and inside vision about ISEC and how it works. So I knew that, of course, it's reliable. It really provides what I'm looking for. So even back then, I was considering this idea, but I guess it wasn't the right time. So I had that idea in, on the back of my head that I should be just keeping an eye on the opportunities and see if something suitable for me comes up. And actually, this one that I was selected for was the only one in my field as a automation engineer that appeared in the search platform. So it was, I don't know, destiny somehow, I think.
Yeah, that sounds good. Also, really a coincidence that you were already in the Netherlands when this opportunity
yes.
showed up, especially
yeah.
during COVID times. So what I was wondering, Justin just told us, and Ella as well, that in our functions, we also want to like guide the people who go on an exchange with us. So how did ISEC help you during your internship, during your exchange?
At the beginning, I had meetings with the responsible person for the outgoing exchanges on the Bulgarian side and also here on the Amsterdam ISEC. So we had like private coaching sessions, so to speak, and they gave me like some materials and some tools that they use in order to schedule their goals in time and also orientate better what you're aiming for during this time period, because sometimes your exchange could last only during the time period that is supposed to be. I mean, sometimes it can be extended, sometimes not. So you should be really focused and very well planning your time so you can get the best of this experience. So that was part of our discussions, how exactly you can optimize your time and better structure your goals.
Okay, so it was partially also about your personal development and your priorities during your internship.
Yes, but also on arrival in Amsterdam area, I had a lot of help from my person responsible for me in order to register here, because it's another country, another new requirements in another province, because I was first in Friesland. So again, I got a lot of help in that area, the communication with the municipality.
So next to that, in Bulgaria, they helped you prepare for going here and getting the most out of your experience. You also got help with like the practical issues with, for example, registration, maybe finding housing in Amsterdam. Yeah,
I also had a person coming with me to see some apartments because at that point I was searching for one alone. And again, I wasn't alone, really. Yes.
Yeah. How did you experience like being supported in that part? Because you said, okay, I was first searching alone and then I wasn't anymore. How was that for you?
Yeah, well, it becomes much easier when you have one more person that is on your side. And of course, it becomes faster, easier, and the experience on the other hand becomes also pleasant in the memories, because otherwise, yeah, when you're coming back to it, it could not be. So it's adding up to the good experience in general.
Yeah. And like, Justin and Ella also talked about like the personal development stuff and the like developing your leadership qualities, reflecting on your experiences. Is that also something that they try to do with the trainees or not really? How do you experience that? Did you get like a space for this?
Yes, I also had meetings with the manager of the incoming trainees here, and we had this so-called Darwin talk, which is again about reflecting on your experience and on the different sides of your goals, because it's important to relate those talks to your personal experience. So you get different questions, and then you relate them to what you've been through and what you are expecting in the future. So it's very nice because you have someone who has an overview about more or less how this is going for other people, so he can give you insights about like, not that you're doing fine or you're not doing fine, but also about their own view on how this experience is supposed to unfold.
So also, you also experienced a support system for your personal development and reflection in that sense.
Yes, definitely. They are always there. Yes.
Okay. That sounds very good as well. I'm glad you had such a good experience.
I wanted to say, especially for the time being, that is in Corona times and all around it. It's also very nice to have this social support, because as a foreigner you might not know many people in the new country, or you might not be so much outgoing to meet people you've never met before. So the ISEC people are really your first point of contact in case you just even need some kind of personal conversation or anything like that.
Oh, that sounds really good. And I'm very happy you got to stay in Amsterdam as well and got hired actually as a normal employee. So thank you very much for your time. We just got some really nice stories about experiences from different ISEC members. But of course, we are here today at ITEA, and for me, the question is kind of sparked a bit. Let's get back to Justin for this. Because how does ISEC and what we do as an organization relate to us standing here organizing ITEA?
Good question. Yeah, so maybe first thing to clarify here is that participating in ITEA is not an ISEC experience, because like, it's not this challenging or practical environment. Organizing this event for our members was definitely a challenging and practical environment. So they had the opportunity to develop those four leadership qualities. But that's not the only reason why we organized ITEA. In ITEA, a lot of international-oriented people come together. And we as ISEC are proud of our mission, and we want to engage as many young persons with our organizations as possible. So that's the reason why we organize ITEA.
Okay, sounds cool. Then right now, I think we have time for some questions in the audience. So I see the first one from Salim Reddy. I find ISEC a great platform, but as an international student, I had a hard time applying when I was wondering if I can still apply, even though I am a senior bachelor student.
Oh, I answer this one?
Yeah.
Yeah. Celine, that's possible. Like, we offer internships for bachelor students, but also master students and also post-master students. So if you're already done with your studies, you can still do a traineeship through ISEC. And not always, but quite often it happens that when you do your traineeship after your studies, like after the traineeship ends, you get hired by that company. So it's actually a very nice way to get your first job.
And she also mentions that she finds ISEC a great platform, but she had a hard time applying. Is there maybe also some way we can help her with that?
Yeah, true. So when you sign up for on our website, we will help you like applying for the internship. So we will look at your CV, if it's like the way as it should be, or we give you advice on how to do your interviews. We can give you an interview training, as we also facilitate right now during the workshops. So yeah, we'll definitely make it easier to apply.
Cool, yeah, sounds good. So the next question is from Catalina. I think you touched upon it a little already, but it's quite a big one. How has ISAC been affected by the pandemic as an organization that does exchanges?
It was definitely a big thing for us. So in March, when all the borders closed, we had to make sure that all our people who were abroad at that moment had to come back to the Netherlands. So that was, first of all, a very challenging period. Then after March, till now, actually, we couldn't do any exchanges. But the people who were already here could stay here. So for example, Anna, who we just saw, she could stay in the Netherlands because she was here for a longer period. And what I just said when we were sitting there, we as ISAC are trying to focus now on a more regional side. So we are more focusing on exchanges within Europe. So in that sense, it really affected us. But still, like, we as ISAC try to develop leadership qualities through challenging and practical environments. And this pandemic is such an environment. So it actually only motivates us more to reach the goal of our organization.
Okay, yeah. That's a really good way to approach it. Also can, I think, nicely be linked to focusing on your span of control, which you talked about earlier. So the next question is, what sets ISAC apart from other career organizations? There's a lot of places you can do internships at.
True. So I think there are two main aspects that make us unique. The first one is that all our internships are organized by the local entities. So for example, if you go on an internship to Bulgaria, for example, we will not be in contact. Like, we as ISAC in Amsterdam will not be in contact with that company in Bulgaria, but the ISAC entity in Bulgaria will facilitate that internship. So it's all very locally organized. And that will really help, like, communication. So if you are there at your internship, you don't have to be in contact with, like, the Netherlands anymore. Like, they will all facilitate it there. And the second thing is that a lot of organizations nowadays are, like, into this personal development, trying to develop their members or their employees, but more as, like, to do besides their normal work. So if there's time left, people can spend some time on personal development. Whereas in ISAC, leadership development is not something we do when there's some time left. No, it's the core of our organization. So the core of our organization is the development of our trainees, of our members. And I think that makes us unique.
Okay, sounds really cool. So basically everything you do, you, within your function and outside of it, you may try to revolve around developing those qualities instead of just doing your job, and next to that, invest extra time into developing the qualities.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so next question. Do you have an age range that you can focus on to develop their leadership skills and to help them find an internship?
For sure, yeah. So earlier I talked about we want to develop those leadership skills in young people. And by young people, we mean people between 18 and 30. So if you're between 18 and 30, you can sign up through our website to do an internship.
Okay. And then next one. How do you prevent ISAC from appearing as a know-it-all organization which determines the rules when you go abroad? It's a critical one, nice.
Yeah. Maybe how should it determine the rules when you go abroad? Now, like, ISAC only helps the people to go abroad with. So in the end, like, the student who go abroad with us is still in charge of where to go and what to do there, like what kind of internship or what kind of volunteering project. But we only help them in the process. So we will never say, you have to do this or you have to do that. In that sense, I wouldn't say that we are a know-it-all organization, and we are really open-minded for all kinds of ideas.
So indeed, it's more of a support system, not a teaching organization in that sense.
Yeah, no, that's indeed important. Like we are not trying to project a certain philosophy on people, as in, we are a non-political organization. Like we don't have a certain political view or something that we try to project on our trainees or members. The only thing we care about is this leadership development, like the development of those four qualities, like self-awareness, solution-orientedness, empowering others, and being a real citizen. And I think those four qualities are so neutral that it's hard to say that we actually are a know-it-all organization.
Okay, so it's just the development of leadership qualities to practical environments, through practical experiences in challenging environments, to work towards making the world a better place.
Exactly.
Okay, then I'd like to give the word back to Katelijn.
Okay, thank you very much, Merel, Justin, Ella, and Anna. I think, and I hope you all now got to know a bit more about ISAC as an organization. I was part of it last year myself as well, so I can really encourage everyone also to look on their website, isaac.com. There's like the opportunity portal, where you can look up job opportunities in different countries. So what we'll do right now is we'll go into another break. But before that, I want to make sure that you guys know what options you have for the next hour. First of all, on the job fair, we will have Information Development Corporation, where you can ask questions to them or get to know the company more. So I would definitely tune in on that. You can do that once again by clicking on the links on the link on top of the page. And there you have the link to go to the job fair. Also, the workshop is starting by Carrière Buddy. So if you signed up for that, you can start with the workshop now also. And if you're still looking for your password or can't find it, once again, use the link and it will direct you immediately to the workshop. So for now, we'll go into a break and I'll see you again in 10 minutes.